Tennessee's number six in the poll. That has happened 14 times in Tennessee history. So 13 times before this year. So how did the Vols respond to that? So let's run through these pretty quickly so that we can get everybody some information. Way back in 38-39, you had Tennessee winning its first SEC championship in 38. How did they do in 39, Caleb Calhoun?
What's better than going 11-0 and winning the SEC in 1938? How about an undefeated regular season and you don't allow a point?
That's pretty good. Season? That's pretty good. 39-40.
What's better than two undefeated regular seasons? How about three undefeated regular seasons in a row? One 10 straight in 1940. Lost the bowl games in 39 and 40, but I got to insist, guys, bowl games were irrelevant back then. They didn't matter. No one cared about them.
Literally like an exhibition when NFL teams used to bounce around before the season and play in Neyland Stadium, stuff like that, if you're old enough to remember. 40-41. So in 1940, Robert Neyland's second stint came to an abrupt end after 1940 as the general was called back to service to train soldiers and help the United States gear up for entry into World War II. W.H. Britton replaced Neyland after his first stint in 1935, and he went 4-5, so there was cause for concern. However, Barnhill guided the Vols to an 8-2 record in 1941. So, again, what did they do in 1940-41?
1940-41, they went, I think they lost one game in 1941, I believe. They lost two. They lost to Duke and Alabama. Went 8-2, finished number 18. Just quick history point. The 1940 election, both FDR and I forget his opponent. I think it was Thomas Dewey. I could be wrong. They were both – the question was who would keep the United States out of the war, and FDR pledged he would, while at the same time calling Robert Neyland up to train troops for World War II. So the United States was always going to enter World War II. Pearl Harbor was just the tipping point for them to do it.
1950-51 and 50, you had an 11-1 season. They did pretty good in 51 as they won a national title.
Yep, their first AP national title, first consensus national title was 1951. They won a share of it in 1950 through some other selectors. Went 10-0 in 1951 and won the national title, lost to Maryland in the Sugar Bowl. But again, bowl games didn't matter. If you guys want to laugh at Kentucky, Kentucky's claiming the national championship for 1950 because they technically won the SEC because they technically played one more SEC game than Tennessee. But both teams had one loss and Tennessee beat Kentucky. So that's the most Kentucky thing ever.
Yeah, I don't think they get to claim championships of that. But everybody does. There were like seven different polls. The Dunkel poll is one that I remember. Ultimately Tennessee should have been considered the championship, no question, in that year. So then we go to we do 51-52 or did we do
we did not.
Okay, 51-52.
So 1952, Tennessee goes 8-2-1, finishes number 8. That's Robert Neyland's last year. He was forced into retirement, early retirement due to health issues. Kind of a sad story with Tennessee. Their most legendary football, men's basketball, and women's basketball coaches all had to retire early due to health issues.
56-57 is one of the years that Tennessee ranked number 6 or higher in the AP poll. They did that in 1956. What did they do in 57?
Then lost Johnny Majors, obviously, to graduation, so they didn't keep up the same success, but they went 8-3, and they beat Bear Bryant in his final game at Texas A&M in the Gator Bowl. To those who don't know history, before Bear Bryant became the coach at Alabama, it was a known thing that Tennessee owned him.
Yep, interesting. 67-68 in 1967, Vols lost their opener 24-20 to the UCLA Bruins, but Dewey Warren, the Swamp Rat, led them to wins the rest of the regular season and to win the SEC 9-1 in both polls and claim a share of the national title. They lost 26-24 to Oklahoma in the Orange Bowl. And what did they do in 68?
68, they went 8-2-1. They tied Georgia in the opener, and they lost at Auburn later in the year. That Auburn loss cost them a share of the SEC title, although had they beaten Georgia and not tied them, they also would have won it. Lost to Texas in the Cotton Bowl, finished number 7 in the coaches, and number 13 in the AP poll.
1970-71, Bill Battle takes over for Dickey in 1970, wins the SEC championship again. A top 6 finish in the AP, number 4 in both polls. 71.
No, they didn't win the SEC in 70, I think. Didn't LSU win it that year? I know Tennessee went to the Sugar Bowl, but I think LSU won the SEC.
Okay, so they go to the Sugar Bowl, number 4 in both polls.
Yes.
They won the SEC championship in 69.
Right. Yeah. That's what I thought. Tennessee was better than LSU that year. LSU had the worst SEC schedule ever. Look at it. It's horrible. But anyways, 71, they go 10-2, lose to Auburn and at Alabama, finished number 9 in both polls, beat Arkansas in the Liberty Bowl, a game known for some controversial officiating that seemed to favor Tennessee.
Okay. So now we get to more modern day football, 85-86. That was one of the most beloved teams in 85, the Sugar Vols. But then 86 was pretty darn brutal. Unranked after losses to Mississippi State and Auburn, both in September. Then the Vols beat UTEP before losing to Army, Alabama, George, and Georgia Tech. So let's bounce to 89-90. Again, a hot and cold sort of thing. The Vols had one blemish on their 89 record. They lost to number 10 Alabama 47-30 in 1990. Alabama got Tennessee again. That was 9-6. Do you remember that game by chance?
I was 2, but I know of the game. I know of the game, and it's
one of the most bizarre endings. I remember being, I guess my parents couldn't find babysitters, and I was at a watch party, and so I would have been, I guess, like. I would have been somewhere like 14. Like 14, 15 years old. And they couldn't get rid of me. And it was a blocked field goal that somehow bounced from Tennessee's 30 all the way back to the other Alabama 30. It would have been Alabama's 30. So it bounced about 40, 50 yards. And that's when Alabama recovered. And there were like 2 seconds left. And they had time to kick the game-winning field goal. It was the most bizarre thing that I have ever seen. So that's what happened in 1990. The Vols did
underachieving team in Tennessee history, I'm going to say.
That's fair. The Vols did finish 8th in the AP poll. 95-96, you're getting in my neighborhood. The Tennessee finished number 3 in the final AP poll with just a loss to Florida on their record. And then in 96, Tennessee was again on the verge of playing for a national championship. And then you had Memphis with the controversial kick return that he was down. His elbow went down, but that was before you had multiple angles. And it was definitely a head scratcher at the time, whether or not he was down. But eventually we saw footage that he was down. 98-99. Tennessee, of course, won the national championship in 1998, and I'll go ahead and tell you that 1999 team was better, period, end of discussion, but I don't think they were as driven. They lost to Florida and Arkansas in a revenge game, both revenge games. They were number 2 and number 3, respectively. Tennessee finished the season 9th in the AP poll. 2001-2002, which was kind of the last highlight, I believe, in terms of national championship pedigree with Philip Fulmer in 2001. Tennessee played in the SEC championship game and should have won that against an LSU team that had 2 significant players in Rohan Davey and LeBrandon Tofield that were deemed out at halftime. And then John Chavis, defensive coordinator, could make no adjustments, absolutely none, to the simple draw. And that's how Tennessee lost that game. Julian Battle dropped an interception that would have been a touchdown. There was a fumble by Dante Stallworth, a fumble by Travis Stevens, and Tennessee could not get out of their own way. Lost that, would have played Miami in the Rose Bowl. I know because I bought my tickets, and maybe I'm the one that cursed them in the press box. Then Tennessee had a brutal schedule in 2002, including number two Miami and one of the better teams that I've ever seen. By the time they got to the Peach Bowl, they got beat 30-3. And I can't remember the linebacker's name that was so good that just made plays all over the field for Maryland. Do you remember him?
Henderson.
What's that?
EJ Henderson.
That's it. Yeah. And he and I coincidentally dined at the same seafood restaurant after the game. I didn't know that, but we did. And I was like, hey, look, there's the guy who just dominated Tennessee. Tennessee finished 8-5 and unranked for the first time since 1998. And then that takes us to.
88.
I thought I said eight.
You said not. Did you say 98?
Say 88. Definitely 98. Oh. They were all better. 2022 to 2023, Tennessee finished 11-2, and 2022 finished the season number six. As for 2023, that remains to be determined. Right now, if you had a bet, if Tennessee will be ranked in the top six in 2023, yay or nay, you would say?
I'd say nay. I'm high on 2024. I'm extremely high on 2024, but I would say nay for 2023. That's.
Do we still have you, Caleb?
I think Caleb. Remember that?
You bleeped out a little bit. Say it again.
Oh, sorry. I would say nay for 2023, but I was going to say I just saw a comment from Chicken Butt. Yes, that's the name on the top right. About the orange roses after the Florida game at Tom Black Track. I'm sure you remember that, Dave, where even
Florida was holding the line. Yeah, I was in Florida. That was really stupid. And the WIVK at the time, and then it was WNOX, came up with that idea, and that was just a bad, bad idea. I heard about that when I was still in Gainesville, and I was like, that's a bad idea.
And didn't Fulmer let Henderson and Stevens fly to the award ceremony that week? The week of the SEC championship game?
I can't verify that.
Okay. I'm going to look that up later, but I've heard through the grapevine, can't confirm it, that John Henderson and Travis Stevens actually went to the award ceremonies because they were for the Outland and the Doak Walker that year. They didn't win it, but the week of the SEC championship game.
I saw Travis Stevens around that week, but he could, you know, nowadays with a private jet, he could have flown back and forth. So there you go. That's on all on offthehooksports.com. If you haven't checked out the website yet, please do. But yeah, the roses were really stupid. Travis says if Tennessee loses two, it will be Georgia and Alabama. So yes, we'll be sixth or better after the bowls. So that's kind of where I am, Travis. If they lose those two, then they're still sixth or better if they play well in the bowl game.